It's AumSum time!
What if everyone went vegetarian? Then I will turn pizzatarian.
No.
Meat industry requires a lot of land to feed and maintain livestock. This leads to deforestation and an increase in greenhouse gases. Turning vegetarian would free up that land, restoring at least 70% of it to natural forests, thus cooling the planet. Also, today there are around 1 billion cows who excrete large amounts of methane. Methane is a deadly poisonous gas, 20 times more harmful than other greenhouse gases. Cutting out meat would decrease methane in the atmosphere. Human deaths would also go down. Chronic illnesses, cancer, strokes, etc. would drastically reduce, leading to reduced medical costs as well. However, the meat industry generates a lot of employment. We would need to think of alternative employment measures if everybody goes vegetarian. But the overall positive impact on the climate, our health, and the planet cannot be ignored. How tattoo removal works?
With the help of waxing strips.
No. A permanent tattoo consists of various colored particles. It can be removed with the help of lasers. Lasers emit light of different wavelengths. The colored particles absorb these wavelengths of light, get heated up, and break into smaller pieces, making it easy for immune cells to eat and excrete them out, thus removing the tattoo. Now, since every color absorbs a specific wavelength more than the other, different colors need different laser wavelengths. Black color is easiest to remove because it absorbs almost all wavelengths and breaks into smaller pieces. However, other colors like red, green, orange, blue, etc. require special lasers. Why is there a hole in the ozone layer?
'Cause I punctured it!
Alright, now listen. Normally, an oxygen molecule contains two oxygen atoms. But in the upper atmosphere, there exists an oxygen molecule which contains three oxygen atoms. This molecule is called ozone. The ozone molecules form a layer around the Earth called the ozone layer. This layer absorbs the sun's harmful ultraviolet radiation and thus protects us. But a time came when the production of human-made chemicals like chlorofluorocarbons, or CFCs, increased a lot. These CFCs began to break more and more and more oxygen molecules, thus thinning or depleting the ozone layer. This depleting ozone layer is termed as ozone hole. However, nowadays, due to awareness, the production of CFCs has reduced to a significant amount. As a result, the ozone layer is slowly but surely getting replenished. Why do we feel butterflies in our stomach?
'Cause I have invited them to my party!
Nah. Butterflies in our stomach are basically caused by our autonomic nervous system, or ANS. ANS regulates our involuntary functions like heartbeat, blood flow, digestion, etc. Also, during stressful situations, such as when a ferocious animal comes in front of us, a part of ANS called the sympathetic nervous system prepares our body for fight or flight. This means it redirects blood from other parts of the body to mostly our hands and legs, so that they get sufficient oxygen and nutrients and thus help us fight or flight.
So then why do we feel butterflies in our stomach?
It is believed that since blood is redirected from the stomach, millions of sensory nerves in it detect a sudden decrease in oxygen. Hence, in response to this, the nerve cells create the feeling of butterflies. Also, because of blood redirection, it is thought that the stomach contracts, thus contributing to the feeling of butterflies.